Thinking about getting into VR? We'll show you some things to look out for when choosing your virtual reality experience.
Wait, how did you hit?
We should mention this video is for those looking to get into a full-fledged PC-based VR experience. If you just want a taste of VR for under 20 bucks, you might want to check out our other video on Google Cardboard here. Before you run to Amazon or Newegg, just know that for two of the most popular VR systems, the HTC Vive and Oculus Rift, you'll spend between $600 and $800 just for the headset and accessories. But the wallet-devouring fun doesn't stop there, oh no. If you need a brand new PC to run these headsets, you can expect to spend $1,000 or more. We'll cover the basic system requirements next, and hopefully you can save a few bucks by using some existing hardware. An entry-level VR system might not be as unreachable as you think. There's a good chance that if you have a newer system from the past 2 years, you only need a graphics card. Here are the minimum VR specs for both HTC and Oculus. A 4th-gen Core i5 with a modest amount of RAM and some spare USB ports should do the trick. The video card is where most people might need an upgrade. VR specs require a higher-end card that's capable of running 90 frames per second. For those who are truly budget conscious, try the AMD RX 480, which starts at $200 and seems to be very capable. To our Mac friends, sorry, but the Vive and Oculus are Windows only. We don't recommend using Bootcamp to run Windows either because by most accounts, it won't work well. Both companies have system checkers to see how capable your PCs are. We'll post the links to those below so you can see where you might need an upgrade. The last thing we'll mention is something you probably didn't think of, how much space you'll need. Both systems offer a seated or standing experience, but what if you want to get up and walk around in your environment? The HTC allows you to walk through virtual worlds. To do that, you'll need at least a 7-foot by 5-foot area that's free and clear of everything. If you've got space to go bigger, you can. With the Vive, you can move around up to a 16-foot diagonal area. You'll see these virtual walls in your headset when you set up your space so you don't go too far. Now go out and have some real fun in the virtual space. But before you do that, give this video the old thumbs up, will ya? Also check out some of our other great DIY videos. My name's Trisha Hirschberger and I cannot wait to play WoW in VR. My life will be over.